The next part of our polynomial equations is looking at end behavior and different things that are associated with our polynomial equations. So the two things that we have are the degree and the leading coefficient. Now the degree of your term is going to be the highest exponent. So in standard form, we're gonna write our equations from highest exponent to lowest exponent. And then in order to find the degree, it's just the highest exponent that you have. The leading coefficient is going to be the coefficient that's right in front of that highest degree. So what I would always do is put it in standard form first, and then you can go ahead and use the degree and leading coefficient to find out your specific end behavior or whatever else you're trying to find. Okay. So the first thing that I want to do is talk about the end behavior really quickly. Now there's two things we're looking at when we're looking at end behavior, and those two categories are going to be, you're going to look at the degree. And you're going to look at the leading coefficient. I'll put that up here on the top. So the degree has two options. Your degree can either be an even number or it can be an odd number. And your leading coefficient can either be a positive number or it can be a negative number. So if you're looking at something that is a degree even and positive, the shape of your graph is going to look like a standard parabola. So your end behavior is going to go up on both directions. Okay, so your ending behavior can be up and down. Now it could have some little squigglies in between. So it could look something like this if it wanted to. There could be a million squigglies, two squigglies, one squiggle, it doesn't really matter. Okay, as long as the end behavior is up and up on both of those. Okay. Now, if you have an even degree that is negative, you're going to follow the general shape of a downward parabola, and that's going to be down, down. Okay. Your leading coefficient, if it's positive with an odd degree, okay, so positive with an odd degree is going to follow the shape of a line. Okay. Now, again, it can have, you know, any type of up and downs, okay, that it wants. However, it just has to start down on the left and go up to the right. And it's going to be the opposite, so coming down the other way. So if we have a negative leading coefficient with an odd degree, it's going to follow the shape of a downward sloping line. So we're going to kind of use that in our end behavior situation. Right. So let's first take a look at a couple of these. Now we have state the degree and the leading coefficient of each polynomial. So the degree and the leading coefficient. This here is already in standard form. So we have our exponent, a highest exponent of 2 comes first, and then we have our next exponent and then our constant at the end. So our degree of this is the highest exponent, which is going to be a 2. My leading coefficient is going to be the number that's right in front of that. So the number right in front of that is a negative 6. So therefore, if we're taking a look back at our chart, okay, we have a degree of 2, which is even, and we have a negative coefficient. So that's going to be over there in the top right corner. So my end behavior is going to be down and down, right? Or it's going to look something along the lines of this. The next thing we want to know is finding the y-intercept. So to find the y-intercept, the x value is 0 on a y-intercept. So if we took a 0 and plugged it into both of these points right here, okay, 0 times anything is 0, 0 times anything is 0, so therefore my y-intercept is going to be at the point 0, 15. The next set here is that these are not in standard form. So 11 and 12 are not in standard form. They're actually in factored form already. So what we want to do is to find the degree and the leading coefficient, you're really just looking for the x's. So if we take a look here, we have x squared times x times x. So altogether, that's going to give us an x to the fourth. Now that's going to be the highest degree that we have. right? Because if we do x squared times a constant, that's still only x squared. If we do x squared times an x, that's only going to give us x cubed. So that's the highest we're going to be able to go is x to the fourth. So my degree is going to be 4, and my leading coefficient is going to be 1. Right? If there was a number in front of this, we'd multiply those together to get your leading coefficient. Now we have an even degree with a positive, so your end behavior should look up and up. Now, to find your y-intercept, or the end part of your graph, we're going to have to multiply the ends of all these. So to find the leading coefficient, the degree, we took the first term of all those. Now we need to actually take the last term of all those. So if we multiply the last term of all of these, you're still looking at x squared. Then you're going to do times 3 and times 8. So the last term of this is going to end up being 24x squared. So 24x squared. Now, if we plug a 0 into this to find out what our y-intercept is going to be, you're just going to get 0, because 0 squared is still 0. Times 24 is still going to give you a 0. Right? So again, to find your y-intercept, you're going to multiply all of your ending terms.